true confession. Betinor is a very attractive, beautiful lady whose presence can make the heart of men melt like hot candle wax. And in all honesty, she is truly in love with Gilgamos. For falling in love with Gilgamos was not hard. What makes her more attracted to him was his big heart, caring attitude, romantic, gentle, and loving. Orion, who was listening to Betinor, cared less about the romantic tales, for he was more focused in luring the paradigm to their location, and at this point wasn't particularly bothered about the Plutonian. But since Betinor knows something that can weaken the Plutonian, he was a little patient with her. As I said before, Betinor loves her husband with all her heart, and most importantly, he makes her feel safe. Their love was like Romeo and Juliet, but for Betinor, their love was too comfortable for her. With Gilgamos, there was no mystery. He was an open book. And moreover, Gilgamos was no spring chicken. He was more than a century years old. From Betinor's perspective, the comfort reeling around Gilgamos seems overrated. But when she came in contact with the Plutonian, she had a crush on him. And behind the surface of her persona, she wanted to know what makes him tick. Trust me, she tried her possible best not to cross that line, for the Plutonian was so mysterious she couldn't let go. In fairness to her, she had caught the Plutonian assassin her from afar, and at this period, she and Gilgamos were not yet married. After one of their life-saving adventures in which she was hurt, the Plutonian came to her aid, and that was when she started to flirt with the Plutonian, whom on most occasions is always professional and cordial around his colleagues. At first, the Plutonian thought she had a concussion, but succumbed to her flirtation, and they decided to go to his hideout, which was beneath a volcano. In fact, it was surprising to her that the Plutonian had a secret hideout. And before they know what was happening, they embraced and kissed. But the Plutonian was wary of his strength, for his body is too tough for her ordinary human skin, for he might hurt Betinor. Then he brought out a candle invented by some aliens called the Naru Visna, which was supposed to be used to attack Sky City, and also discovered that when he puts the candle on, it makes him mortal. And when he did put the candle on, he became mortal. And before you say Jack Robinson, they consummated and make passionate love. According to Betinor, it was the best she ever had, and Gilgamos can't touch him. But while this was going on, for some reason, she asked the Plutonian to look straight into her eyes, and what she saw was terrifyingly reverting to comprehend. So in fear, she took a piece of the melted candle with her without the Plutonian's knowledge. And even with that confession, Orion hit her to tell him where she hides the candle wax. Charybdis, I mean our hero survivor, discovered the broken wings of Gilgamos and summoned the rest of the group, including Cubit. And he asked Cubit what he had done to Encanta, if she got any information from her, in which he lied to survivor that she hasn't given any useful information, and that is because Cubit doesn't trust survivor's judgment or mental state of mind. While at the same time, Encanta was metamorphosizing into binary numbers. And with the expertise of Cubit, they were able to pinpoint the location of Gilgamos and Betinor, which was due west of their standing. So immediately, survivor took the rest of the group to the location. The Daniels had kept themselves in isolation, hiding from the Plutonian even before he lost his marbles, for they were his foster family when he was young. They were so afraid of him that they used sign language to communicate, and they were taking care of their younger brother who needed special attention. To their surprise, or to their dismay, the Plutonian located their hiding place, and Samsara, who is inhabited by Modius, was with him. You see, their parents adopted the Plutonian when he was 5.5 years old, but when he became 7 years of age, he was returned back to child services because they were terrified of him, mainly because when their little brother was born, he wasn't disabled. But for one fact, that when the baby was given to Plutonian when he was a toddler, not knowing his own strength at that time, mistakenly squeezed the baby, and this resulted in their younger brother needing special attention, for he became disabled. What really hurts the Plutonian the most is that the Daniels kept mute after he left, and saying that he had saved people 1,000 times over, they are still afraid of him. Seeing Orion holding Gilgamos and and Betunor, captured, Survivor wasted no time in making Orion know of his presence, which delighted him, for he let Betunor understand that he will use her secret that he told him as a bait of distraction, and he knows it will psychologically kill them, knowing she lied and betrayed them.